Come on. Gotta get the Skrilla, gotta get the Skrilla, gotta get the cash. Hey, come on.
Daphne Codebreaker, 1, 2, 3 pins Hamada. Velvet pins ODB, and they each have keys. Okay? So they're at the end of the night, they were supposed to say what happened. Who gets the fucking belt?
Okay.
Who has to do a striptease in the ring?
Okay.
Who gets a contract to face anybody?
Okay.
And I think ODB said she wanted to face AJ Styles. I mean, there's just all kinds of stuff going on. They never got it off, by the way.
I bet you Russo booked that segment.
Lacey showing off her Mach 1 skills. Lacey ended up in a singles match with Angelina Love at the end of it, and she did a great job.
You know, Lacey won on Russellicious.
Well, good. Good for her. All right. Moving up to keep the viewers on TNA, Kurt Angle versus Anderson in a ladder match. No commercial break. Timing, perhaps? Oh, wait. There's the commercial.
All right. You're going to get this segment, because just mark it down, because here's what I got coming up. David Blochunka, backstage again, with 427 green M&Ms. I don't get the joke there. 427 green M&Ms. Is there some kind of joke there that I don't fucking know
about? There's 420 green M&Ms. I get it.
That I would get. And then, oh, here's one for you. The A-List. No, not Jeremy Yeager or Todd Shelton.
Or OC.
No, he's looking for the A-List, but Santino comes in and wants the A-Team.
Oh, God.
Hornswoggle, green M&Ms, blah, blah, blah. It was funny, but you're going to get that segment.
Okay, well, you know, I'm going to give it back to you because Angle versus Mr. Anderson starts. Angle gets hit twice, and we go to commercial. I mean, literally.
Okay.
We came back. It's TNA because WWE just started blah, 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 commercial.
All right. Well, my sixth segment of the night, which is the third match of the night, Show Miggs versus Dave Berg and John Cena.
That's an easy call.
No, it was cool because it was only a 2-minute squash match because why is Batista going to, you know, tag with Cena? They just wrestled at WrestleMania, so he just walks out after 2 minutes. And then Otunga comes out and says it's going to be Miz Show versus Cena and Otunga for the main event. So, yeah, then we go to commercial.
You got that.
Decent segment. It was cool. Okay. I liked it.
All right, segment 7. Angle almost blows a groin entertaining us. Check out the clip.
And I think Kurt's going to get it, but hurry up, Kurt.
See? He almost got destroyed.
Oh my God, he could have got a concussion.
This ladder match was amazing. Pay-per-view quality.
Yeah.
Everything. Moves, psychology, even the camera angles and close-ups. When you watch this, you're going to be amazed. Wow. JB and Hogan.
Got an angle in it.
Backstage. First time JB goes up to Hogan, you can see he was worried. Interference by the Love Sponge. And the band arrives and we go to commercial.
During the ladder match, the Love Douche comes out?
No, after.
Who won the ladder match?
I'm going to say I'm not really concerned with it because I don't want to blow the ending, but you have to watch it. You have to watch it. I don't want to blow an angle match because this is one that ends up on DVD and you're going to love it. The ending was phenomenal.
All right. Hey, I appreciate you not blowing. I'm going to check it out tomorrow. Let's see, what am I here? Segment 7 now? That's
segment
right.
Segment 7.
All right, Debussy, baby. This is how it should have been booked all along. Teddy Debussy coming out with the $1 million belt. That's how it should have been done 2 fucking years ago.
I agree.
And then we come out and we get a beautiful Debussy versus Christian match. Nice neck breaker. Christian, when he got back into the ring, right? He not like a Steph KO, but he was like swung him with a beautiful swinging neck breaker. Nice move, and the match lasted 4 minutes and 20 seconds, and it ended with the Dream Street.
Wow.
I get that segment.
Oh, yeah, you definitely do.
I like the match.
Segment 8, backstage with Christy Hemme, Matt, and Morgan. Yes, he thinks he's two people now. He always talks about we and us. He's got both belts, and get this, he is defending both belts.
With no partner.
No, there's two of them, Matt and Morgan. We are defending the belts. Okay, fourth match, 3D versus the Motor City Machine Guns.
I need a bog in after that.
The winner gets to fight Matt and Morgan, okay? The both of them. The crowd, we want tables. No, we don't. We want tables. No, we don't. Interference by the band on a great match.
Oh,
lots of finishers, but no jackknife powerbomb. Wouldn't even try it. Just did a clothesline.
Is that your eighth segment?
Yeah, we got a commercial.
You win. I had an HBK video package that was the same shit I saw at WrestleMania, same shit I saw last week on Raw, the same shit I've been seeing for a while.
Wow.
It's
4-3.
I fast forward.
Enter the Love Sponge, segment 9. Big Kev says he's running the show in the middle of the ring. Tells Hogan, we've been carrying your punk ass for years. And then we're running the show now. Backstage, JB and Pope, interference by Wolf. AJ match on the line. Pope says,
wait a
minute,
gonna
beat me
wait
again.
A minute, whoa. Slow
you
your
can
roll.
Wrestle AJ.
Slow your roll. The band and
Kevin.
Fucking...
Kevin,
no, Kevin
Paul
and the
Pac
in the love
middle
douche,
of the ring.
And the love douche are
yes.
gonna run fucking TNA.
They say they're running the show.
Fans, are you fucking kidding me?
For life, for life.
This is not 1998.
We go to commercial.
Yeah, thank God. Okay, thank fucking God.
How are we doing on time?
We're doing fine on time. I've got about 5 more minutes left.
Oh, beautiful.
Alright, so check it out. Segment 9. I got the 5th match of the night. This is Lucky Lager Swagger versus Baby Oil Stone Cold Orton. That's right. Champion versus Chump. But unfortunately, the Chump won. This is like the second week in a row that he beat fucking Jack Swagger. He lays him out earlier in the show. I don't understand where you're going with this. Swagger, I understand he got the belt. It might be kind of cheesy. Yeah, the Money in the Bank.
It's
nice
to have Swagger angle as champ now.
It is. I mean, look at his outfit. He's got the whole Curry. It was the bar, Curry Angle's outfit.
I'm waiting for Pyros.
Comes out, the fans start chanting, "You suck! You suck!"
Really?
No, I'd be funny.
Well, let's
if they
start
didn't.
It.
All right, well, actually, I go to segment 10 before that. I just kind of covered up 9 and 10 all together, so.
Okay, well, my segment 10 was a gauntlet match. Douglas Williams, as
okay.
he prefers to be called, versus Generation Me. He beat them both.
Okay.
But both Generation Me guys were incredibly good even apart. These Young Bucks can really get the job done. I hope you got that one.
Yes.
Great job and way to represent Southern California. You're not from Los Angeles. You're from Southern California.
Actually, from the Inland Empire, so that makes it even more
that's
precise.
Right.
You know,
but,
why get technical?
And then interference by Shannon Moore. He's got the Book of Dilly Gaff, and he's welcoming people to glam rock. And when I saw this the first couple times, I thought it was really stupid. I'm starting to like it. I don't know why, but I think Shannon Moore is the only Hardy that never got any pop. And I think he's ready for a shot, a legitimate shot. He is. He's a missing Hardy. He trained with them since they were, what, 4?
Shannon Moore.
It's sleepovers.
Shannon Moore is adequate at best. And I'll leave
so
it
far.
There. I'll leave
so
it
far.
For his whole fucking career, and I've been watching him since WCW.
What is he
got?
One match every 2 months?
I've been watching that guy for 10 years, man. I remember him in 3 count back in with Evan Courageous.
Dilly Gaff.
Yeah, Dilly Gaff this, all right? Anyways, let's go on. Okay, the match continues, actually, this 10th segment. Orton, I said, wins this match by reversing the Doctor Bomb. That's right. Dr. Death Steve Williams created that move. It's the Doctor Bomb. And he gets the RKO. It was a nice reversal. That's basically how Orton wins the match. It was about an 8-minute match, though. So how are we going to score this?
Well, I had an angle. At the end of it, I had an angle and Anderson ladder match going on, so I got to take it. I mean...
Oh, yeah, the angle...
That was going on in this
yeah,
segment.
Yeah, take the angle Anderson, yeah. Ladder match. I'm not a fan of Anderson,
yeah.
But...
And it was the end. When you see the end, you'll understand.
Okay.
Very emotional.
Dang, what is that? 6-4?
No.
5-4.
It's 5-4.
I gotta win this last segment to tie
okay.
it up and see what happens.
Okay, segment 11, the beautiful people touching each other again. Go to commercial.
Okay, you get that segment. I don't have a segment. That's just, again, beautiful people touching each other. I mean, hello? Do we need any more than that? All right, my main event, I guess, here, we'll wrap this up here. We got Big Show in the Miz Show, of course, versus Otunga and John Cena in the tag match. Huh. This match went about 6 minutes. It was decent, a little back and forth. Otunga showed some promise. And then he says, fuck you, Cena, I'm walking out. Leaves. Big Show knocks him out. They pin him, win the match.
Really?
I was really cool with that. Yeah,
cool.
Fuck John Cena. Pin his ass, beat him up. Then Batista comes in. Dave Bird gives the freaking... You know, Batista bomb himself, gets the mic, gets the spotlight. Glad to see you have it back, because he cuts good promos when he has the spotlight. And he's going to challenge him to a last man standing match at Extreme Rules. Huh. Now, again, I like the way they closed the show, making us fans know that Batista is still the top heel in the company. And do I see a title switch here? No. But who knows? Let's see how the further weeks of Raw lay out.
Huh.
So that's why I closed the show.
All right, segment 12, backstage Wolfpack versus 3D next week. It's never happened. 15 years. Main event, Pope versus Wolf. Crowd, Pope is pimping. Clap, 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 clap. Pope's boxing skills are phenomenal. Wait till you see him. Hope hits a killer codebreaker. 1, 2, 3. Interference by AJ with a run-up so quick, the cameraman got run over. Interference by Abyss with a yellow stripe of Hogan on his pants and Hogan music. He has his own Abyss. Na-na-na-na, cause I'm Abyss. Some bullshit. Team Flair takes the advantage, like they said at the beginning, and TNA cuts out with no logo and no women shit. They blew their time, but, you know, they did their thing.
Okay, all right. All right, so all...
I got it!
You did, you got it. You
TNA wins!
TNA wins.
Raise my hand.
3-2. That's how it is. After 5 weeks, TNA has cut back. Let's hope the ratings are better as well.
Yeah, it's not going to happen.
And that's about it. We're running out of time for the adult demographic. Monday Night Wars. Drop us your comments. Let us know what the better show of the week was. This has been sponsored by Miller Lite, Cohiba Cigars, straight out of fucking Havana, Cuba.
Shut up, bro.
Peace.